Connor, commiserations. All in all, are you all feeling a little bit hard done by at the moment?
Massively. It's constantly happening. It's ridiculous. People talk about VAR, but they don't ask us about the situation. I think for me, it's not working, but a lot of people would say they're getting the right results and things like that. I don't know. It's the fact you give decision and then your head around the decision and you can change it for handball and different things and then the offside. I can't get my head around it, honestly God, I can't get my head around it. I think it happened against Manchester City, where we managed to come back because we showed character. I thought we were fantastic today. I thought we showed people how Wolves play. We got at Liverpool, we created chances, I think, especially in the first half. I think you've got to realise, especially second half, sorry, but I think you've got to realise first half they come out and they pressure. It's such a tough place to go, but we control the game second half. But decisions are killing us. It's killing us, it's constantly against us, and people are telling me they're getting the right decisions and whatever. We're the players on the pitch and it doesn't feel good, believe me.
But clarify for us what you feel, what the Wolves players feel was chiefly the problem with the only goal of the game in the end. It wasn't necessarily what VAR were checking.
For me, I speak to Anthony Taylor during the game. He's a great fella to speak to, he really is. He's fine, he's fine to speak to. But you ask him questions, you don't really get an answer. We thought Van Dijk had handballed it as well in the lead-up to the goal. That's what we thought. And then he tells me that Van Dijk's too far away. So I can't get my head around it. Van Dijk plays the pass for the goal. He's a fantastic player, unbelievable player, and it's a brilliant pass. But by sounds of it, he handballed it. So I don't know where we're going wrong, I don't know what the confusion is. But for me, it's not good because that's twice on the spin now against Liverpool and Manchester City, the two best teams on the planet at the minute.
As a player, how do you feel VAR, the way it's being used at the moment, is affecting the game?
It is affecting the game. The crowd are singing it. The crowd don't like it. No one likes it. It's something where it's tough. No one asked the players about it. No one's asked us it. They come in and done a presentation at the start of the season and told us what was going to happen. But it's still confusing. You still don't get your head around it. It's still hard to... Because you don't get answers on the pitch. They kind of just tell you, right, we're checking for a penalty. We're checking for handball. We're checking for offside. Okay, so who's offside? We don't know. So how far offside? We don't know. We don't get told. I couldn't tell you, honest to God. I've just heard an armpit or something again, is it? Armpits are coming quite the rage in the Premier League at the minute, so one of them.
Tell me about the positives that you will take from this performance. You've come up against the runaway league leaders. They've dropped 2 points all season, and you're giving them a game.
Yeah, showing how we play. We'll never change the way we play. We play a certain way. We listen to our manager every single game, and we listen to him. Well, I say in the week leading up to it, we had one day to play against the two best teams in the world, so it's madness. But we come here, we showed how we wanted to play. And like I said, second half, we really controlled it. We created chances. We could have scored a couple as well. So all in all, I thought we played really well. I did.
Liverpool have obviously built themselves a fantastic platform for 2020. What kind of platform have Wolves built for next year?
Just keep improving. And we don't look at where we want to finish at the end of the year. We don't look at what we want to do. We want to keep on winning as many games as possible. We felt like we could have won today. And we felt like second half we should have got something out of it. But the situation happened and it was how it was. But for us now, it's looking at Watford. It's a massive game for us in the new year. And it's something we're looking forward to now.
Appreciate your time.
Thank you.